out that loud. It just feels so liberating. First of all, let me start off today's episode by wishing Kenyans all over the world a happy Mashujaa Day. Oh, good God, that is a handful. That is a mouthful. And you know what? In retrospect, I was thinking about everything that's happening in Kenya. So first of all, I'd like to send shout outs to you. Wish you a happy Mashujaa Day. Good Lord. And as I was doing that, I first asked myself, right now you're going through a lot of things, you know. Someone needs to break you off a little bit and say, you know what, our people, we are out here, we love you, we love you, we feel for you, because you're going through some very, let's just say, shitty times, in for lack of a better word to say. I mean, if the only guy on the ballot paper who's represented by the image of an apple decides he is going to step away from something that he called back, I mean, it's just so messy. But come to think of it, as all of that is going on, and I know you're going to be doing your voting soon, there's a guy who I watched on Jeff Koinange, the only son of a nomad, I think that's his thing on the ballot paper. That guy was so uniting. Not that I'm taking sides for him, but he sounded so uniting. He sounded uniting and he sounded good. In a nice kind of way, in a different kind of way. So you should give your thoughts to that guy. I mean, since the Apple guy is not going to be pretty much going through with it, just thinking out loud. Yeah! Anyway, that's enough of me sounding like I'm very smart right about now. My name is Tina Fierce One. Welcome to yet another day of daily, beautiful, amazing, juicy gossip all the way from Uganda. That's me trying to sound like a Mzungu. Get it? But let's see, what's trending in Uganda at the moment? Well, let me start with the one that is irking me in places. It is making me so pissed off. Every time I think about it, I actually get an upset stomach. Like, it just bothers me. Why two people can't grow up? Now, yes, I know most of you always go like, oh, Tina, don't talk about Bobi Wine. Oh, Tina, don't talk about Bobi Wine. I'm tired of hearing that. And as you've noticed, I will talk about Bobi Wine because, one, he's in my jurisdiction. He happens to be a politician who was in my lane. Music. So I still have to talk about him, because even when he went into politics, he stayed in my lane. So I will talk. Though there's a new entrant to my talking point today. Andrew Mwenda. First of all, there has been this whole back and forth. The back and forth is so annoying. It is so annoying. I don't even have words. So Bobi Wine sits down, spends like about 2 hours typing down an open letter. And that's how they're starting. I am tired of all these open letters on Facebook. Whenever you open up Facebook, you just say, an open letter to the president. An open letter to Andrew Mwenda. An open letter to Charles Odong. An open letter to Tina Fierce. You are writing open letters to everyone. And we are sick and tired of it. Now, someone was like, but Tina, honestly speaking, if you're very pissed off and miffed about what's going on between the back and forth between Bobi Wine and Andrew Mwenda, what would you say? Who do you think took the other to school? Who educated the other on terms of politics and all of that, blah, blah, blah? And here's what I have to say. No one educated the other. Both of you sound like dumb, ignorant fools to me. You just sound like two little girls whining about who the boy hugged first at the prom night. It's just annoying. You spend 2 hours typing down a long letter with stupid facts that we don't care about. First of all, Uganda reading. My girl Razia Athman sat down and she thought about it. Ugandans don't like to read. We hate reading. We are more visual. Show us like a video, show us this, imagery. We will be there. But you spend 2 hours writing to each other back and forth on social media. And I ask myself, how about, other than wasting your time, 2 hours you're writing, no Ugandan is even going to make sense of it. Situka, go to Andrew Mwenda's office and tell him what you have to say. Get to his office and tell him, you know what, I could not type this on Facebook. So here's what I wanted to say, and express yourself. Same goes for you, Andrew Mwenda. The only beautiful thing, though, about Andrew Mwenda being on Facebook and the whole back and forth is that I don't get to hear his squeaky, annoying voice. You know, it sounds like a rubber duck. Whenever he talks, you go like, huh? I mean, I thought David Beckham was annoying, but no! Andrew Mwenda's voice is just way too much. So I'm lucky that I don't have to hear him going like, this Bobi Wine guy does not... That's the only upside to it. But other than that, y'all is wasting time. There's very big issues happening in the country and you're dealing with the trivial things. Still talking about trending things in Uganda. So, there is this whole... I know I talked about the UPRS situation with artists, and I didn't know how big the magnitude of it until I was shocked a bunch of artists, the biggest we know. Some of them were there. There was Radio, there was Cindy, there was, what was Rem, what is her name? Rena? What was Rena Narumansi doing there? What did she even have to say? But they were all, they had gathered and they were pissed. They were spitting fire. You know what? Let me just give you a feel of what was happening there. Just watch this clip.
The young people. War is for old people to talk and young people to die. Shut up! I want to hear somebody young, not these old people. When did you last sing a song? Or you? You don't remember, I was not yet born.
Okay, so here's the thing. UPRS, these artists are claiming, for us we did not sign with UPRS, but they are taking our money. For us we did not do this, but they get money from us. And in my mind I'm like, okay, it doesn't add up one bit. Then mutandisono kweku wabu koko la temwera, by the way. You're looking like fools. One guy comes on and he's like, nze, artisti wange, te assigning anechi ne UPRS. Mwamu chimeka, ngariru vuto ne mumuwe mitwala na, tamanyi zaachi. Mama, na ye nazi kwata. Do you see the irony of that? If someone comes and hands you money that you don't know about, you're like, whoa, wait, what is this for? And then they're like, banenga weba le kuyimba nyimba. No, zikwata, it means you are in agreeance. You are actually part of the whole situation. So why are you crying foul? Nzebana Ugandan artist Kambabulira, we are dealing with a lot. We cannot deal with this too. They're all there screaming, yelling. Radio, banenga, if Radio had flesh on him, he would have. If I keep on imagining that they got the Hulk's temper and put it in Schmigo. Do you know what that means? Like the Hulk in Schmigo, that is what Radio is. Like he embodies too many temperaments in him. And he's also there screaming, yelling. I'm like, okay, not bad. But let's imagine for a minute, let's imagine this, that if all of y'all could wake up in the morning and say, UPRS, stop dealing with my stuff, cause you the artist, you start moving from bar to bar to bar to bar to club to TV to radio, where tambuli de where car, and see how much money your song is going to generate. Because and another other thing though, I mean the artists are going to get pissed off at me because I mean this is their hard work, you know, it's their hard work. So I also have to look at the other part. Why isn't UPRS saying anything? Guess what? Chameleon opens up another group. So there's been this hashtag, Save Ugandan Music. From who? We don't know. But the hashtag is there. Musicians have opened up a WhatsApp group. Good God, that is so professional. They have opened up a WhatsApp group to Save Ugandan Music. Talking about the same Save Ugandan Music. So Winnie Nwaji was under fire a couple of days back. I know I'm never on Winnie's side. I don't hate her. I just... We'll talk about Winnie's situation on me later. But Winnie, poor girl, was excited that Whiskey Dayo is coming to Uganda. So she took to her Twitter and she's like, yeah, it's confirmed, it's a deal, he's coming to Uganda. And everyone was like, we are here fighting to serve Ugandan music and you're here calling in a Nigerian artist. I was like, whoa, now that's petty, that's salty, that's different. But I want to understand this whole Save Ugandan Music. From who? Is this... Maybe this is how it's working. The artists are telling us to save Ugandan music from UPRS. I don't get it. But you know what I'm going to tell you right now? Both UPRS and the artists, we are dealing with a lot as a country. To Charlie Wano, we have to deal with Bobi Wine's back and forth with Andrew Mwenda. We have to watch all these late night televisions. We are thinking there is still Chifesi out there. The economy is still so bad. Very many people are still unemployed. There is new stuff every day. It is so much going on and we cannot afford to sit and pile this one also on us. So here is my suggestion, artists. How about you, UPRS, and the music that you're trying to save, I don't know from who or for who, how about we can stop listening to your music? Mugende yo mutule, sort out your problems with UPRS, save your music. When you're done saving the music and talking to UPRS and getting your ish together, you can come back to us, because in that meantime, we'll be dealing with what's really happening. And Besides, there's way too much Nigerian music. There's way too much bubblegum music coming from Hollywood. There's just a lot to occupy us. Just do not stress us more. I said, I don't get it. We have tried. We have tried. And we can't be part of your drama all the time. What pisses me off about Ugandan artists is that they're the same guys who cry foul. And then when we listen to their music and we try to judge them according to what we feel, they call us out for not being patriotic. Then they start saying, you only want Ugandan music. We're putting a lot of money. And then you rob us clean. And then you never buy our music videos or our stuff. You just download it for free. And I'm like, okay. We do all of that. But do you know how much drama you bring to the table to us Ugandans? Do you know? Do you even know what happened to the days when, man, I would just have an artist, I would love their music, I would listen to it, no drama, but y'all is coming in with so much drama. I don't know if it is the economy or if we have evolved as an industry that things are becoming too real. First of all, beginning of the year, guess what the song was? Copyright law. Those are the artists. Then before we had that, Kawesa was standing somewhere. You're suing. Then another time, there's Morris Kiria. Before we know it, there's this nonsense. Before we know it, the DJs. It all evolves around music. Can't you just let us enjoy your music drama-free, man? That's all we're asking for. We want to love your music. We want to enjoy your music. But we don't want to come with all, we don't want it to come with everything that comes with it. It's like you're trying to vibe a girl. You like her. You dig her. You really, really want her. And then she tells you, hold up, I got my passe right here, I have my best friends and there's family here, and then there's the kids at home, and then there's too damn much. Mutuyambe, mutwesonywe. Go sit down in a little corner and huddle up, beat yourselves up, talk to UPS, go ban their studios or whatever it is that they use. Is it an office? Shut the whole procedure down. Open up my WhatsApp groups. You, the artist, sit there. Mubereyo. Because it's too much. By the time you're done with that, we will have cleared our plates for y'all. In the meantime, the Nigerians got us. We'll be right back.